Hello, I'm Jane Reeves. The woman I'm visiting today is a former fashion model, a successful entrepreneur, a mother, and a wife, and they say you cannot have it all. Without any further ado, I'm pleased to introduce Mercedes Matsuo. Yeah, where's my audience? I will come back to the Matsuo part a little later, but let's get started. Buenos dias, minha querida, como estás?
Muy bien, ¿y tú cómo estás, Jane?
Have I nailed the accent?
Perfect.
I tried.
That was really good.
I practiced, can't you tell? So I kind of gave it away a little, but humor me, where are you from?
I'm from Spain. I was born in Zaragoza, Spain, the north of Spain.
Okay, and this, I actually looked it up. It's on the border with France, right?
Very close to France, about an hour and a half from France, I'd say, yeah.
Okay, and this is an autonomous territory, right?
Yep.
Aragon.
Aragon, correct.
Yep. What is it known for? How is it different from other parts of Spain?
Aragon is known for, well, first of all, we have a ski resorts in the north, Huesca, which is the one that is closest to France. That's the province of Huesca. We have a lot of truffles. We grow a lot of different, you know, crops for the cold weather. Mm-hmm. Zaragoza is known for the cathedrals and the churches and the museums. Mm-hmm. It's a nice city, about 1 million people live in it.
Okay.
And Teruel is known for the jamón, so, and the olive oil. It's very famous for it.
So you probably like to cook, right?
I love to cook.
I will ask you at the end for the recipe. You see, every time I visit someone, I don't cook, so I always try to get a recipe. Not that I will ever succeed, but no one can blame me for the lack of trying. So how many languages do you speak?
I speak 5 right now, but I studied 8 languages.
Wow, which are?
I studied, well, believe it or not, English, Spanish, obviously, French, Italian, German,
okay.
Greek, Catalan, and I studied Russian for 1 year, but I can't say much.
Как
по-русски. That's all I remember.
That's actually one of the benefits of growing up in Europe, you see. So now let's get all the stats. How tall are you?
I'm 5'11".
And in metric system, it's
183.
Okay, so I have all my girlfriends, or most of my girlfriends, are very tall, 5'10", 5'11", 6". And add high heels to that, I feel like a pygmy. That's why I can never stand right next to a Mercedes. Anyway, let's talk about your modeling career.
Okay.
How did you get your break?
I started when I was 14 years old. I was discovered. I mean, it's like the word that everybody uses, but I was walking down the street, typical story in Zaragoza. A designer found me, that he saw me, he wanted me for his fashion show. So I said yes, and mm-hmm. I did a fashion show, and then from there, you know, it was just slowly, I did some beauty contest and I won. And then from there, I just started getting, like, you know, agencies all over the world, so.
So you mentioned to me before that you come from a conservative Catholic family.
Oh yeah.
What did your parents think? Did they encourage you?
The modeling?
Yes.
The thing is, my mother, well, imagine that they were born during the Franco era. So, and this was, they were born right after the Civil War of Spain. Mm-hmm. So their parents were even more conservative than they were. Mm-hmm. My mom was a very beautiful lady, and she couldn't really fulfill her dreams. So I felt to a degree that my mother always wanted me to do what she couldn't have done in her life. Mm-hmm. And but my father, he was a cop for 45 years, and he was very tough on us. Uh-huh. I don't think he liked it too much. But my mom was happy with it.
And you were probably making already good money, right?
Yeah, I mean, I made some money with modeling, I have to say.
You said that you would get, look, what, 5 to 10,000, not pesos,
no,
dollars for
one
work,
day,
right?
Yeah.
It's really impressive, especially, like, yeah, what, you were in middle
for
school,
for a 23-year-old,
right?
Yeah, 20, 23-year-old mm-hmm. girl. I mean, it's
That's
pretty nice.
Really, really nice.
Yeah.
So the world of fashion is changing, like, yeah, anything else. Any Me Too moment that you recall and can share?
I mean, sure. I mean, you find it's an industry where you feel like if you are not friendly or forthcoming, or, you know, like, you don't behave the way they want you to behave, you're gonna be cut out. So, I mean, there are moments where that I have been uncomfortable, and I think it has happened to all of us. You know, photographers that were inappropriate, in Italy, you know, for example, or
But let me ask you this.
Oh, go ahead.
You come from Europe.
Yeah.
And even when the Me Too movement started,
right,
there were a lot of very famous big French actresses, one of them. I should double check actually my sources. I think it was Catherine Deneuve. I think she's one of the most beautiful women actresses in the world. I think she might have said that it's an exaggeration. I think in general, people in Europe, the culture is more relaxed. Do you feel like it's maybe, I mean, what do you think personally?
What I do think personally, I mean, yes, there are times where you feel uncomfortable and there are people that are inappropriate, but for the most part, I'd say that it is not the case. Not all the time, at least. And I mean, it came to a point in this country, I believe, I was in Los Angeles at the time, where we were like, nobody's gonna be allowed to even like put their hand on your shoulder or do anything to you because, oh, God forbid. And I think it's been an exaggeration. Mm-hmm. I mean, definitely if a person that is in that position wants to go ahead and do something, I mean, they know what they're doing. I'm sorry, but that's how I feel about it. If you don't want to behave like that, you just cut it off, which is what, you know, most of us do, I think.
And then your career suffers, right?
It could or it could not. I mean, it could suffer.
But you need to know when to draw a line.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. Otherwise, you will never be respected, I believe.
I hope I'm not disclosing a big secret, but you mentioned to me that you recently turned big 5-0.
I'm 50.
Girl, you look fantastic.
Thank you.
First of all, you have classic beauty features. Your skin is glowing. You look awesome. I know that you still model on and off and aside. Why do this at this age? Is it a challenge? Is it boredom? Why?
Why not? It's fun. You know what? I miss it. Yeah, okay. I miss very much the thrill of being in a fashion show.
Are you naturally comfortable in front of camera?
Yeah.
Is it a taught thing? Is it?
I'm very comfortable. I'm very much.
Even when you started, right? You didn't need any classes?
No classes, yeah. I mean, you grow into it, obviously. You know, in the beginning, you're not as loose as you should be. Okay. And then as you do more and more photo shoots, it becomes like, you know, second nature.
Any memorable photo shoot or, I don't know, fashion show that stands in your memory?
I did a photo shoot with Ralph Lauren with Bridget Hall.
Okay, Bridget Hall.
Bridget Hall, yeah. So I was with her, I worked with her.
I know that you were, by the way, Victoria's Secret angel, right?
Not an angel, this is before the angels.
Oh,
so okay. I was actually on TV with Victoria's Secret long time ago.
So angels is...
The angels was after I had done that, actually, okay. Yeah. But it's been a fun career.
Can you please address ageism in fashion industry? Does it exist? Is it getting maybe a little bit easier now with inclusivity, with diversity? What's your stance on it?
I think so. I think it's getting easier. I think it's getting more accepting. I still believe that in Paris, you know, they still measure you, make sure you're not putting on weight.
Oh, really?
Every month, yes.
Oh my God. What, if anything, are you grateful to modeling? And maybe you can offer advice to young girls who aspire to become models.
You know what it's given me more than anything is confidence. It's given me the opportunity to travel the world, to meet different people, and to speak my languages, you know, everywhere I go. So I think it's a very rewarding thing to do for a little bit of time. Not forgetting that you have to study and do something else, because eventually you get old.
Actually, yes, let's switch gears and talk a little bit about education, the value of formal education. While you were making good money you also went to school, University of Saragossa, full-time.
Right.
And received your Bachelor's of Arts in Philology. Philology is study of language. It's not very widely used term here.
It's not.
Yes. Why was it so important for you to go to school and get a degree?
Well, I have to thank my father for being very, he was the one that really pushed me to never abandon that goal. And so I never did, but I think that modeling was fine, but I never saw it as something that I was gonna be doing forever. And I loved languages because of my friends, you know, ever since I was 5 years old. Mm-hmm. I had friends from France and Italy and other places. So it was important for me to be able to communicate. I think you must finish. I mean, if you have a vocation for anything, you must finish what you start.
You see, girls, bottom line, go to school. So later, I know that you moved to London to take marketing classes on the one condition, which was?
I had to live in a convent in the middle of High Street, Kensington.
How was it? What was it like? I mean, I can't, with nuns, right? You have to get up like at 5, 6.
We didn't. So basically we didn't have to get up early in the morning, but if you didn't get up early enough, you wouldn't have breakfast. So, okay. But we did have a curfew at 10 p.m. at night. So if, and I was only
no
20.
No dating, right?
Well.
That's a completely separate story, right?
Exactly, yeah.
So through modeling, you moved to America.
Yep.
And you went to Malibu, California. Mm-hmm. Another interesting fact, you were taking some acting classes with a family friend, which was who?
Jonathan Banks. He's done a lot of like important films in the past, but he really became very well known with Breaking Bad. And then Better Call Saul, and you know, he's done a few things lately.
And you played such a vicious, scary character on that show. How's he in real life?
He's amazing. He's very caring. He's a nice, nice man. Mm-hmm. Very much so. I've known him for like 30 years now. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, he's married to a Spanish woman.
Ah, that's why.
Yep.
I see.